बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू स्टोरी एंड फॉर दैट यू ऑल शुड ओपन योर नॉवल। द नॉवल जो मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस वाला आपका नॉवल था वो आप लोगों ने खोलना है, और उसके अंदर आपने फोर्थ स्टोरी जो है हेमलेट ये आप लोगों ने खोलनी है। कम ऑन, टेक आउट योर नॉवल एंड दिस इज ओके। यस, फोर्थ स्टोरी हेमलेट। नाउ आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट विलियम शेक्सपियर, यू नो इट इज अ स्टोरी बाय विलियम शेक्सपियर। आई टोल्ड यू एट दैट टाइम व्हेन विलियम शेक्सपियर, इट्स अबाउट 400 years बैक, दैट At that time, the stories they were mostly written in such a way that they were not they were like they were written in such a way that they could be performed on stage, because at that time there was no cinema and there was no television और ये सब। तो entertainment क्या होती थी? थिएटर। अब थिएटर की जो एंटरटेनमेंट है, थिएटर मीन स्टेज। So all the stories they were written in such a way that they could be staged, they could be performed on stage. ये एक तरीका होता था। That is why whenever you will read these stories, the stories that you have got, this is the easy version of the stories. Otherwise, if you will see that, if you will read the actual, the original stories written by William Shakespeare, I'm sure you will not understand even a single line of it, because at that time English language was very very much different from the language that we have today, and this book is written in the easy version. It is converted in such a way so that we can easily read it, and the words that are known, you know, there are many words that do not exist in today's language. That's why they are changed, they are converted into the new words, easier words, so that we can understand the story well. All right, now Hamlet, I will tell you a short summary of the story, and then we will start with the story, first chapter of the story. Now, the story is about a prince. Hamlet is a prince, and he's a young boy. But then, he lives happily. He's a student in a university student, and then what happens that suddenly his father, the king, actually, he dies. And how did he die? Everyone came to know suddenly that a snake bit the king. Ek saanp ne snake usko king ko kaat liya, and he died. This was the story which everyone came to know, and obviously the king was a very popular person. Everyone liked him, so people were very unhappy. They were sad, and then what happened? That in place of king, his brother, king's brother Claudius, he was made the king. उन्हें किंग बना दिया गया, और क्लॉडियस एज कंपेयर टू द ओल्ड किंग वाज नॉट अ गुड पर्सन, ही वाज अ विकेड पर्सन, एक चालाक मकार इंसान था, और बहुत ही उसकी ये बात थी कि वो उसके अलावा भी, यानी के उसकी ही वाज एन अगली पर्सन, एंड The old king was very very popular among the people. Anyways, obviously Hamlet loved his father very much, so at his death Hamlet became very very upset. But then what happened that when even after the death of the king, in less than 2 months of his death, his mother, Hamlet's mother, she remarried. उन्होंने दोबारा शादी कर ली, and the man she married was Claudius, the king's brother, and who is obviously the new king now. But this was more upsetting for Hamlet, because Hamlet never liked Claudius, and he always he did not want to see him. He never gave the place, he never gave Claudius his father's place. He never thought of him as his father. कभी भी उसको अपने फादर की जगह वो नहीं दे सका. Anyways, what happened then? Okay, let's start with the story. The first chapter, the unhappy prince. The unhappy prince, when the king of Denmark died suddenly, the life of his son, the young prince Hamlet, changed completely. Make sure that you have your pencils in your hand so that when I will tell you the meanings of the difficult words, you will keep on writing the meanings so that you will understand the story better. All right. Now, it is a story of which country? Denmark. Denmark ki story hai ye. And what happened that when the king of Denmark, Esan Munip, stopped doing these stupid things. So, when the king of Denmark died suddenly, all of a sudden, the king of Denmark died. And the life of his son, the young prince Hamlet, changed completely. And the death of the prince, death of the king, changed the life of his son. King ki death ki wajah se kya hua? Ke uske bete ki. And who is the son? The young prince Hamlet. Hamlet uska beta hai. And he is a young prince. Ek young boy hai. He is the prince, obviously. Uski life bilkul change ho gayi. Hamlet had loved his father, a kind and popular king. And Hamlet, because he was very much attached to his father, he loved his father very much. And not only because as he was his father, obviously apne father ke saath sabki attachment hoti hai, magar iske alawa, king himself was a very kind person. Ek bahut acha insaan tha, jo old king jo the, wo bahut hi ek acche insaan the. Aur iske alawa, that is why he was very, very popular among the people. People liked him very much. When he died, the prince was terribly upset. Terribly means buri tarah. Terribly, buri tarah. And obviously, when the king died, jab king ki death hui, to jo prince hai, he was wo buri tarah se upset ho gaya, bahut zyada pareshan ho gaya, bahut zyada uski life bilkul change ho gayi. He became very, very upset, very sad, very disappointed of his life. And okay, he became even more upset. Even more means usse bhi zyada. Pehle hi wo bahut dukhi tha. Upset means dukhi. Bahut dukhi tha, buri tarah se dukhi tha. Aur he became even more upset. Aur usse bhi zyada dukhi wo kab ho gaya? When his mother, Queen Gertrude. Now, who is the mother of the prince? The queen, obviously. Unka naam kya hai? Gertrude. Queen Gertrude married again. Now, this was more upsetting for Hamlet that his mother, she remarried. Dubara shaadi kar li, unhone dusri shaadi kar li. It was, and Hamlet was not happy at that, less than 2 months afterwards. Aur ye bhi ek bahut ajeeb baat thi, ke it was not even 2 months of the king's death that the queen remarried. Abhi 2 mahine bhi king ki death ko nahi hue the. So the queen jo hai, unhone dusri shaadi kar li. The man she married was the old king's brother Claudius. And the man she chose, वो इंसान जिसे उन्होंने चूज किया था शादी के लिए, वो कौन थे? वो किंग के भाई थे और उनका नाम क्या था? क्लॉडियस. सो क्लॉडियस इज द मैन हु इज द किंग्स ब्रदर एंड द क्वीन गर्ट्रूड प्रिंस हैमलेट्स मदर शी मैरिड क्लॉडियस इवन इन विद इन लेस देन 2 मंथ्स ऑफ द किंग्स डेथ. ठीक है जी. ओके. Prince Hamlet was shocked and angry at this. And this was very, very upsetting. Shocked ka matlab hai sadme mein aa jana. Hairan ho jana. Something very unexpected happened to him. Bahut hi ek aisi cheez jiska Hamlet ne kabhi bhi expect nahi kiya tha ki aisa ho jayega. So Prince Hamlet was very upset, very shocked, disappointed, बहुत सदमे में आ गए, angry at this, and at the same time he was not, as he was not happy, उन्हें बहुत गुस्सा था इस सारी चीज पे, because he did not want his mother to marry again, and that also with Claudius. He did not like Claudius actually. He would never accept his uncle Claudius as his new father. और Claudius को वो कभी भी अपने न्यू फादर के तौर पर एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर सकता था. ही डिड नॉट लाइक क्लॉडियस, एंड व्हेन द क्लॉडियस वाज हैड टेकन द प्लेस ऑफ हिज फादर, दिस वाज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल फॉर हैमलेट. ही कुड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ हिज मदर कुड लव हिम, एंड दैट वाज बिकॉज ही कुड नॉट थिंक ऑफ इवन अ सिंगल रीजन. कोई एक वजह भी उसे समझ नहीं आती थी कि व्हाई हिज मदर, Why the queen? How could she love him? वो Claudius को कैसे पसंद कर सकती हैं? Because Claudius was not such a good person. He was not such a person कि जिसको पसंद किया जाए या जिसके बारे में कोई अच्छे ख्यालात रखे जाएं. Claudius had no concern for the feelings of other people. Concern का मतलब होता है फिकर करना, किसी चीज के बारे में सोचना, किसी चीज के बारे में ख्याल करना, किसी चीज के बारे में परवाह करना. तो क्लॉडियस वाज सच अ पर्सन कि उसे किसी की फीलिंग्स की, किसी दूसरे इंसान की फीलिंग्स की, ख्यालात की, उसको कोई परवाह नहीं थी. ही वाज नॉट सच अ पर्सन जो दूसरों का ख्याल रखता है. ही डिड नॉट केयर फॉर एनीवन, किसी का भी ख्याल उसको नहीं था. ही वाज सच अ पर्सन, ही डिड नॉट केयर एट ऑल, ही नेवर केयर्ड फॉर एनीवन, उसे किसी की परवाह नहीं थी. Compared to Hamlet's father. Now, if you compare Claudius with the old king, अगर आप Claudius को compare करें king के साथ, तो you will see that Claudius was a foolish, ugly man. कैसा इंसान था Claudius? He was a foolish man. Foolish means he was very a stupid kind of person, idiot, foolish, bewakoof, ugly. He was not good looking at all. Bilkul bhi good looking nahi tha. So Claudius was not such a person. Ye soche ki bhai koi banda bada intelligent hai ya koi bahut good looking hai. Koi baat to usme aisi honi chahiye ki his mother got attracted towards him. Koi aisi baat nahi thi. At least Hamlet could not find any such thing. Any such thing which was all right. So when the prince saw his mother and Claudius so happy together, he was very angry, and because prince did not like Claudius, he was not happy at this marriage. Is shaadi pe wo bilkul khush nahi tha. So afterwards, whenever he saw his mother and Claudius laughing and happy with each other, enjoying their life, he always became very angry and very upset. Wo hamesha bahut gusse mein aa jata tha jab bhi wo Claudius aur apni mother ko ek saath khush dekhta tha, hanste bolte baat karte hue dekhta tha. It was as if her tears at the old king's death had all been lies, and he started feeling one thing. Ek baat usne sochne pe majboor ho gaya tha. He thought that maybe when his father died, the queen, obviously she was crying bitterly, bahut buri tarah ro rahi thi. She was very sad, she was very disappointed, she was very upset, and she was crying. To Hamlet ko aisa lag raha tha ki if she was really sad, how could she marry within 2 months of his death? यानी अगर उनको इतना ही दुख था तो वो 2 महीने के अंदर दोबारा शादी कैसे कर ली. सो ही थॉट, ही स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग, सो ही स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग दैट मे बी ऑल दैट सैडनेस एंड ऑल दैट फीलिंग्स दैट शी वाज शोइंग, वो जो दुख और जो सब कुछ क्वीन के चेहरे पर उस वक्त नजर आ रहा था, मे बी इट वॉज ऑल ड्रामा, इट वॉज ऑल लाइज, और मे बी सो ही थॉट के हो सकता है कि उसकी जो मदर है वो जो इतनी दुखी नजर आ रही थी उसके फादर की डेथ पे, वो सब झूठ था. शी वॉज नॉट सैड एट ऑल, शी डिड नॉट, मे बी शी डिड नॉट लव हिज फादर. सो उसको ऐसे लगने लग गया था. Hamlet could not forgive her for forgetting his father so quickly. And he started feeling bad for his mother also. He did not like Claudius, one thing. He started feeling bad for his mother, second thing. He loved his mother, but whatever she was doing, he did not like that. That's why he started disliking his mother also, hating his mother also. And he could not forgive her. वो उसे बिल्कुल माफ नहीं कर सकता था. किस बात के लिए? For forgetting his father so quickly. That she forgot. किस बात के लिए माफ नहीं कर सकता था? कि उसने उसके फादर को इतनी जल्दी भुला दिया था. वो इतनी जल्दी भूल गई थी उसके फादर को और उसे दूसरी शादी कर ली थी. And she was happy once again. Hamlet could not accept all these things. All right. Were all women so quick to forget the men they once loved? And because he was very upset, so he started thinking negative. Usko negative thinking uske andar har cheez ke bare mein aati ja rahi thi. Even he started feeling thinking negative for his own mother also. And he started thinking in such a way that all the women of the world, they are like that. They are not faithful to their husbands. उसे ऐसे लगता था कि दुनिया की सारी जो women होती हैं वो सारी इसी तरह की होती हैं कि they love a person and then they forget that man so quickly. तो उसको ऐसे लगना शुरू हो गया था because he was very upset. So उसकी thinking बिल्कुल negative होती जा रही थी. Hamlet could not think of anything but his father's death and the marriage of his mother to Claudius. Now, he was a prince. He had so many things to think about. But at this moment, at this stage of his life, Hamlet thought about two things only. Sirf do cheezon ke bare mein wo har waqt sochta rehta tha. Aur wo do cheezein kya thi? One, his father's death. And second, his mother's marriage to Claudius. यानी ये दो बातों के अलावा वो किसी और बात के बारे में सोचता ही नहीं था. Nothing else seemed important. He did not. He found everything else very unimportant. हर चीज उसके लिए बिल्कुल unimportant हो गई थी. कोई अहमियत नहीं रही थी किसी चीज की सिवाय ये दो बातों के. And he kept on thinking and thinking and thinking about these two things. That's all. Even his dear friend Horatio. Now. He had his best friend, dear friend, Horatio, could not make him forget it for more than a moment. Horatio was his best friend and he liked him very much. But even Horatio was not able to make him busy in something else. Wo bilkul kamyab nahi ho saka tha is baat mein ki wo koi bhi, ki wo apne, ki wo Hamlet ko kisi aur taraf laga sakta. किसी और चीज में बिजी कर सकता. वो भी इस बात में कामयाब नहीं हो सका था कि वो एक मिनट के लिए भी अपने फादर की डेथ को भूल जाए या अपनी मदर की मैरिज को भूल जाए. Horatio kept on, he tried his best, but he was not able to make him normal, bring him back to his normal life. उसे उसकी नॉर्मल लाइफ में लाने में वो कामयाब नहीं हो सका था. Hamlet refused to stop wearing black clothes in memory of his father's death, even after everyone else had stopped wearing them. Now you must have noticed, जिन लोगों ने English movies देखते हैं या जो उन्होंने ये जरूर देखा होगा कि in English movies whenever somebody dies in Christians, when someone dies, all the people they wear black clothes. सब लोग black कपड़े पहनते हैं जब किसी की death हो जाती है. And that is for the funeral, जो जनाजा होता है जब उसकी last सारी वो होती है उसके लिए वो लोग black clothes पहनते हैं. And then after that for one or two days the family members they keep on wearing black clothes and after that they come back to their normal clothes. बाद में वो अपने normal जो भी कपड़े colors पहनना शुरू कर देते हैं. But Hamlet, he refused to stop wearing black clothes. अब जैसे कि उसके फादर की डेथ को काफी महीने गुजर चुके थे, but even now, Hamlet used to wear only and only black clothes. अभी भी वो सिर्फ ब्लैक कपड़े पहनता था. उसे जब दूसरे कोई कपड़े पहनने के लिए कहा जाता था तो he always refused. हमेशा मना कर देता था. Why? Because उसके माइंड से उसके फादर की डेथ उसकी मेमोरी में से जा ही नहीं रही थी. he kept on thinking about his father's death all the time. That's why he did not stop wearing black clothes. उसने बिल्कुल भी काले कपड़े पहनने नहीं छोड़े, even after everyone else had stopped wearing them. And even when all other family members, they stopped, they were not wearing black clothes anymore, but Hamlet was wearing only and only black clothes. Everyone noticed Hamlet's behavior, and this worried Gertrude and Claudius. Notice means observed. Jaiza lena, har kisi ne is baat ka, har kisi ki nazar mein ye baat aa gayi thi, har insaan ne, har kisi ne ye baat notice ki thi. क्या नोटिस किया था? His strange behavior. Hamlet का जो अजीब सा बिहेवियर था, इसे सब लोगों ने नोटिस किया था. And this worried Gertrude and Claudius. And Claudius and Gertrude, obviously Gertrude was his mother. And Claudius, they were worried at his behavior. उसके इस बिहेवियर पे वो दो लोग बहुत ही परेशान थे. They hated to see Hamlet come before them, dressed from head to toe in black and looking so unhappy, and they did not want to see Hamlet in black clothes. उन्हें बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं था कि जब भी वो उनके सामने आता था, वो सर से पैर तक ब्लैक कपड़े पहने होता था, और उसके फेस पर एक सैडनेस नजर आती थी, उसके फेस पे एक डिसअपॉइंटमेंट अपसेट नजर आता था वो हमेशा. And Claudius and Gertrude, they did not like this. बिल्कुल उन्हें ये अच्छा नहीं लगता था. He reminded them continually of his father's death, which for different reasons they both wanted to forget. और क्यों वो उन्हें पसंद नहीं थी ये वाली बात? Because whenever Hamlet came in front of them, whenever he came, जब भी वो उनके सामने आता था, तो reminded means याद दिलाना. तो वो उनको उसके ब्लैक कपड़े क्या याद दिलाते थे? Continually means लगातार, मुसलसल. तो जब भी वो उनके सामने आता था, तो उसके ब्लैक कपड़े उसे मुसलसल उन दोनों को याद दिलाते रहते थे ऑफ हिज फादर्स डेथ, किंग की मौत की याद दिलाते रहते थे. विच फॉर डिफरेंट रीजंस दे बोथ वांटेड टू फॉरगेट, विच ऑब्वियसली क्लॉडियस एंड गर्ट्रूड दे वांटेड टू फॉरगेट किंग्स डेथ. वो किंग की डेथ को भूल जाना चाहते थे, वो उस दुखी पार्ट को, पार्ट ऑफ स्टेज ऑफ देयर लाइफ को भूल जाना चाहते थे. दे वर हैप्पी नाउ इन देयर न्यूली मैरिड लाइफ, दे वर हैप्पी, सो दे वांटेड टू फॉरगेट किंग्स डेथ. दैट्स व्हाई. बट व्हेनेवर हैमलेट केम इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम, हिज ब्लैक क्लोथ्स ऑलवेज रिमाइंडेड देम हिज द किंग्स डेथ. दैट्स व्हाई दिस वाज वेरी अपसेटिंग, एंड दे हेटेड टू सी हिज ब्लैक क्लोथ्स. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द न्यू किंग एंड हिज क्वीन आस्क्ड हैमलेट टू कम एंड सी देम एट कोर्ट. I told you court का मतलब होता है दरबार. And as they were not happy, as they did not like this whole thing, that is why this new Claudius, new king, obviously he was the new king, and Queen Gertrude, they called Hamlet, they asked Hamlet to come to the court. उनको ये कहा गया कि वो court में आए. Hamlet को बुलाया उन्होंने court में, because they wanted to talk to him about his strange behavior, about his upsetness, about his unhappiness. Uske bare mein wo usse baat karna chahte the. And when he came to the court, what did they say? Dear son, try to forget about the past, his mother said. Now when he came to the court, uski mother Queen Gertrude, what did she say? Unhone kaha, dear son, pyare bete, try to forget about the past. Past means maazi, guzra hua waqt, ke tumhe koshish karni chahiye ki tum guzre hue waqt ko bhul jao. Everyone has to die sometime, you know, and you know, this is a fact of life. All of us, anyone who is born has to die someday. Har insaan jo paida hua hai usne ek na ek din zarur marna hai, so this is natural. So queen ne ye wali baat usse kahi ke this is not something out of this world. Everyone has to die, everyone has to go out leave this world one day. Ek din to sabko ye duniya chhod ke jana hi hai. Don't make yourself even more unhappy. So you should not make yourself so upset, so unhappy, so sad. Yani ab tumhe chahiye ki ab tum apne aap ko is baat ke liye sambhal lo you should accept this fact that your father is not in the world anymore. So you should not be so unhappy. Make yourself normal. His uncle followed Gertrude's loving words with a long and clever speech. Now, Claudius, when Gertrude said these words, after that, Claudius, he followed. Followed means, उसके बाद उसने जो है वो Claudius ने जो है वो Gertrude के बाद क्या बात करनी शुरू की. Gertrude ने तो बहुत ही प्यार से बहुत ही loving words बोले थे उसको समझाने के लिए. But Claudius, he started, he gave a clever speech. Clever, बहुत ही चालाकी के साथ एक short speech उसने दी. Because he wanted everyone at the court to know, to think that he loved Hamlet very much. उस वो ये चाहता था कि कोर्ट पे जितने भी कोर्ट में लोग दरबार में लोग मौजूद हैं वो सब ये सोचें कि वो हैमलेट से बहुत प्यार करता है. सो ही गेव दिस बहुत चालाकी के साथ वो ये इम्प्रेशन कायम करना चाह रहा है. यंग हैमलेट ही सेड, उसने क्या कहा कि हैमलेट टू मच अनहैप्पीनेस एट समवनस डेथ इज फूलिश. व्हाट डिड ही से, ही सेड दैट बीइंग सो अनहैप्पी एट एनीवनस डेथ, किसी की मौत पर इतना ज्यादा दुखी हो जाना इज फूलिश, ये तो बेवकूफी है. Only children behave that. This is not, he said that you are a young man. So children cry and become upset like this. Usne kaha ye chote bacche is tarah se behave karte hain. Tum, you are a young man. You should not behave like that. Face facts. Facts means hakikat. Facts means hakikat. Face facts, tumhe hakikat ka samna karna chahiye. Since the beginning of time, every son has lost his father. Because this is natural. Ye dunya ka, kudrat ka ye usool hai ke ek din har ek beta apne father ko kho deta hai. Ek din aisa aata hai, har bete pe aisa waqt aata hai ki uske father ki death ho jati hai. That is the way of life. Aur zindagi ka yahi tareeka hai. And now, Hamlet, you have a new father. और उसने कहा कि और अब हैमलेट अब तो तुम्हें फिकर करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है because you have a new father. He said like he was, who is the new father? Claudius. Claudius is saying that now I am your father. I am your new father. Believe me, I love you like my own son. And he said that I am your new father and you should believe me. Trust me that I love you like my own son. मैं तुम्हें अपने सगे बेटे की तरह प्यार करता हूँ. In front of all these important people, I say this. और वो कोर्ट में है खड़ा हुआ है, दरबार में खड़ा हुआ है और वहां पे बहुत सारे मिनिस्टर्स और लॉर्ड्स और ये सब लोग मौजूद हैं. उन सब के सामने वो कह रहे हैं, इन सारे इंपॉर्टेंट लोगों के सामने मैं तुम्हें ये कहना चाहता हूँ, यू विल बिकम किंग आफ्टर मी, दैट यू आर जस्ट लाइक माय ओन सन एंड यू विल बिकम किंग आफ्टर मी. एज दिस इज अ ट्रेडिशन दैट अ सन बिकम्स किंग आफ्टर द किंग्स डेथ. So, उसने कहा कि जब मेरे बाद तुम किंग बनोगे, because I love you like my own son. So, I think of you like my own son. Yes, मैं तुम्हें अपने बेटे की तरह समझता हूँ. My boy, we are worried about you. And he said that, मेरे बेटे, हम तुम्हारे बारे में बहुत परेशान हैं, upset about you. We really are concerned about you. So we do not want you to go back to university in Wittenberg, as we know that Hamlet is a university student and his university is in Wittenberg, a name of a place. Wittenberg, वहाँ उसकी university जिधर वो पढ़ता था. तो अब उन्होंने कहा कि as you are upset, you are not normal, and we are worried about you. So we do not want you to go back to university in Wittenberg. यानी this is some other place, some other city, some other state. उन्होंने कहा कि हम नहीं चाहते कि तुम अब अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी वापस जाओ विटनबर्ग एज यू प्लान, बिकॉज यू थॉट लाइक दैट. हैमलेट ने ऐसा प्लान किया था, ही वाज गोइंग बैक टू हिज यूनिवर्सिटी इन विटनबर्ग, बट क्लॉडियस सेड दैट वी डू नॉट वांट यू टू गो बैक टू योर यूनिवर्सिटी. योर मदर एंड आई वुड लाइक यू टू बी अ गुड सन टू योर पेरेंट्स एंड स्टे हियर विद अस. एंड ही सेड दैट इट्स नॉट ओनली माय विश, योर मदर आल्सो विशेस द सेम. शी सेज शी has a wish that you stay here with her and unki aur meri ye khwahish hai ki tum hamare acche bete bankar hamare sath yahan par raho. Hamlet ignored Claudius. Acha, ab ye sari itni lambi speech Claudius ne ki hai, but Hamlet, as he did not like Claudius, क्लॉडियस वॉज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट टू हेमलेट एट ऑल, वो उसे बिल्कुल अहमियत नहीं देता था, ही इग्नोर्ड हिम, बिल्कुल उसने उसको निग्लेक्ट कर दिया, इग्नोर कर दिया क्लॉडियस को, बट टोल्ड हिज मदर ही वुड स्टे इफ शी वॉन्टेड हिम टू, और उसने अपनी मदर से कहा कि ओके फाइन, इफ यू वॉन्ट मी टू स्टे हेयर विद यू आई विल, मैं यूनिवर्सिटी नहीं जाता हूँ, अगर आप चाहती हैं मैं यहाँ रहूँ तो मेरे, बट ही डिड नॉट गिव एनी इम्पोर्टेंस टू क्लॉडियस. ऑल राइट, नाउ दिस इज ऑल, यहाँ तक आप लोग इसकी डेट लगा लें. दिस इज ओके पेज 51 लाइन नंबर 20 तक हम लोगों ने पढ़ा है. आप इसको यहाँ पर अपनी डेट लगा लें, आज की डेट टुडे इज 13th of July, आप यहाँ पे लगा लें. एंड ऑल द वर्ड्स दैट हैव कम इन बिटवीन, डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स जो मैंने मीनिंग्स भी आपको बताए हैं, ऑल्दो यू ऑल हैव द वोकैबुलरी लिस्ट ऑफ दिस स्टोरी इन योर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर वर्कबुक, सो इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम रिगार्डिंग द So, anyone who has any problem with any of the difficult words, you may open the vocabulary list in your English literature workbook and you can have the meanings. So, it's a very interesting story, Hamlet. We will continue the story tomorrow, inshallah. And I hope you all are doing fine. If anyone has any questions till now, you may ask now. Yes, we will continue with the story tomorrow, and I hope you liked it till here, and I want you all to, if you have time, maybe you can continue with the story, read it yourself, and let's see, we will talk about it tomorrow. All right, thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.